welcome back to Men's Rap at 18600 Wyoming at the Detroit Inner City Alamo. Today's topic is men's rap, and we have some guests here tonight, and we'll be discussing issues on men's rap. Today's guests are Mr. Zachary Wright.
Good evening.
And we have a new guest this evening. His name is Adrian Robinson.
Good evening. And
he will be discussing issues concerning men's rap. I would like to refer to the fact that the last time we were here, we talked about young men and men mentoring them. Today, we want to go a little more in depth and talk about men mentoring men and how we can best help one another. Mr. Wright will probably elaborate on some of the basic issues, and Mr. Robinson will maybe give us some color as to why men have to mentor men. So without further ado, I'm going to let Mr. Wright start out the conversation on men's rap. You have it, Mr. Wright.
Good evening, everyone. Glad to be here again to cover this subject matter with the little time we do have on men's rap. Last week, we covered as much as we could. We wanted to elaborate on the fact that the times in which we were born was, we're out of the baby boomer theory.
Yes.
We're baby boomers. Mm-hmm. Now we, the young folks now are living in what is known as entitlement, the age of entitlement. And basically, they feel like whatever their parents have, be it a business, be it houses, be it property, be it finances, that you should hurry up and expire and give it to me.
Yeah.
You know, there's actually been parents that have lost their lives because the children believe this so much so that it turned into a psychosis, you know. And we grew up, as Mr. Bloomfield said last week, in an era where if you were just seen doing something wrong, Mr. or Miss So-and-so would whoop your behind.
Yeah. Yep.
And you might get two whoopings before you get home to get the main whooping.
Right. You would get two.
And times are just different.
Yes, they are.
And they can be a bit confusing because I wonder what the children's mindset will be 10, 15 years from now, because they're seeing men not judging homosexuality or anything like that, but they see a lot of it on television. You know, they co-sign it, men kissing men, women kissing women. And I just wonder the effects of that on them. Like Mr. Bloomfield said, it takes a man to raise a man. But that isn't the case. There are a lot of females in the urban area and the suburban area that have children, and they're left with the task of raising young boys, of raising young men.
But Mr. Wright, wouldn't you say that we're of a different generation?
Absolutely.
Now, Adrian, Mr. Robinson, what is your take on the fact of men mentoring men?
Good point. I believe men mentoring men, as Mr. Wright was saying, a woman can't mentor a man. Mm-hmm. And part of men mentoring men, it goes to who better could you look up to than a man? And show you your different outs and your wrongs. A lot of times, youth today don't have nobody to point their wrongs to them. I can, as I was coming up, I would look to, even if it was a neighbor down the street, and his actions, I could take his actions and look, and he would tell me, boy, you gonna be all right, or boy, you know that's wrong. So, yeah, and I had that. And today, I feel like Sly Stone said, babies making babies, you know, and babies raising babies.
Well, Mr. Robinson, I'd like you to hold that thought for a minute. We're gonna take a brief break, and we'll be right back with Men's Rap.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.